these are all skaters from the U.S. Figure Skating Association. They come here to try and augment their performance, whatever jump they happen to be working on, that they can almost do it, but they just can't quite get there. And what this process allows them to do is sort of get that little extra competitive edge by actually analyzing the biomechanics of their jump.
So we want them to pick a jump that they're not super comfortable with and they haven't quite perfected. Maybe they're not spinning the entire number of revolutions that they need to accurately complete the jump. More often than anything else, it's the arms. And so in order to spin around, you need a really tight center of mass. And so they'll have their arms out like this, and that prevents them from spinning as fast as they need to.
In order to define the most accurate biomechanical model, we need to identify all of the body segments. So the arms, the legs, the chest, the trunk.
With those markers, we can recreate their body. So we know where it was at any point in time on the ice and how it moved. Once we've obtained that data and cleaned it, we can then use it in a simulation. So when the skater's in the air and they're jumping, we can then look at their position and then find a more optimal position for them to get into so that they have a higher probability of landing the jump.
Biomechanics in general is something that when I was in college I had no idea about. My background is math, but it turns out you can apply math to really cool things, whether it's patient care, physical therapy, or sports like this. And so it was really important to me to find an advisor who was active in all of those areas. And Dr. Richards definitely runs the whole gamut. He thankfully let me come along for the ride.